Hello students, I'm Jitendra Chahal and I have brought one more video for you from the English book Communicate in English, class 8. And the chapter what we were discussing in the previous video, that is the last stone mentioned from unit 2, section 2. The last stone mentioned, right? And in that previous video, we have completed up to this portion where his son, the old stonemason's son, left him and he went away. And then just after that, his servant, whose name was Salim, he came in with a steaming glass of tea for his masterji. Masterji means honor, master, right? So he brought that tea for the master. And this old stonemason called that boy, beckoned that boy and asked him to sit down on the ground. So now let us move for the next. Let us move further. The old man looked up. Salim, he said gently, soon I will be the last stonemason here. All the others would have gone to Agra. Now the old, after making him sit nearby him, the old stonemason told the told Salim that he would be, the old man would be the last stonemason in that area or in that place, okay, because all the other stonemasons, they had already gone to Agra in order to earn more money, in order to learn other things in the field of sculpting or stonemasons field. Okay, they wanted to earn more money and they wanted to make other things from the stones other than the statues of the gods, right? So they had already left, and he thought that the old man told that he would be left alone, he would be the last stonemason in that area or in that place. He told this thing to his servant Salim. There they are turning out cheap candle stains, paperweights and ashtrays by the dozens. Okay. And then the old man told there those people, those who went to Agra, those people, they were creating, those people were creating candle stains, paperweights and ashtrays, right, for earning more and more money. And which were not good for the stonemason, and the stonemason didn't consider that a great and good thing. They are making money, but they betray our skill, our age-old tradition. Obviously, definitely they are making money, but they are deceiving, they are cheating their skills and their age-old tradition. Means they have gone there. And what is their tradition? Their tradition is to carve the sculptures for the temples, and they are not following those people, the people, those who went to Agra for creating different things with the stones. So they are not keeping their tradition, and they are not worrying about their tradition. They are deceiving that, according to the old stonemason. Now Gopal has also gone. I will have to finish this sculpture alone, and with the help of God, I will do it, Salim. Now, the old stonemason told that his son Gopal, he had also gone, and now he had to finish that sculpture alone. And he told Salim that with the help of God, he will be able to finish that sculpture properly and within the time. He was sure, the old stonemason told this. I know you will, Masterji, the boy answered. You will make many more larger and more beautiful temple sculptures. And the boy also told, because the boy trusted the old man very much. So the boy Salim, he told, I know you will make and you will finish this sculpture very well, Masterji. And not only this, you will make some more sculptures larger than these. Okay, means he trusted on the old man, and he tried to encourage the old man. Okay. The old man looked at the orphan boy who had come to work for him 5 years ago. Now this Salim, he had come to this old stone mason 5 years ago. Okay, and Salim was an orphan boy. Okay, orphan who doesn't have parents, means whose parents are not there in the world, whose parents have died. So that person, that child is known as orphan. So Salim was an orphan and he came to this old stone mason before 5 years. Okay, drenched to the skin, dressed in tatters, he had begged for shelter during a furious monsoon storm. Actually, what happened, this boy Salim, when he came to the old stone mason, at that time it was raining heavily. Okay, and this boy was drenched totally. Okay, and his dress was tattered, means it was old and torn, the clothes were old and torn. So that boy came to this old stone mason and asked for the shelter from the rain, and had stayed on to work for the old master craftsman. He had grown tall and strong. The old man knew that Salim too would leave him one day. Okay, so the old man gave him the shelter and this boy stayed with this old craftsman. The young boy stayed with this old craftsman, and now this young boy Salim had grown up and tall. Okay, and this old man thinks that, this old man stone mason thinks that one day there would be a day when this boy Salim would also leave him and he would also migrate somewhere else. He sighed and looked into the serious eyes of the boy, clouded with sadness, a sadness the old man could not understand. Okay, then the old man sighed. Sighed means to take a deep breath and then to leave it. That is called sigh. Now this sigh can be made in the way of relaxation or in the way of showing disappointment. Okay, so here the old man is disappointed. Okay, that's why he sighed. Okay, and then he looked into the young boy's serious eyes, but he could not identify the sadness which was there in the young boy's eyes. Okay, the old man could not understand the sadness which was there in the young boy's, Salim's, eyes. He shook his head. My strength is waning. Now the old man shook his head because he told that my strength is waning. My strength means I'm getting weak day by day, right? He was getting weak. I can't work with the chisel like I used to. Carving takes too long, much too long. Now the old man told that he could not work with the chisel too long. Okay, because now he was getting old. And he says that carving takes too long, means carving a stone takes very much time. Okay, very, very much time. So it was now it was difficult for the old man. When he was young, at that time he could do with the chisel, he could work for a long time with the chisel and hammer, but now it was difficult for him because he got old, he grew old. Then he straightened up and said with fresh determination, I will have to finish this work and surely I will. Then suddenly something happened to him. The old man straightened himself and he told with a determination that he will have to finish that work and he would finish that work. He told this with determination. Yes, you will, the boy repeated, offering his master the glass of tea. Drink please, it will do you good. Now the young boy also encouraged his master. He's told some encouraging words and he told, yes master, of course you will be able to finish this work. Okay, but before that, you please have this tea. He offered a glass of tea to his master and he insisted his master to drink that tea, to have that tea, because the young boy told that this tea, if you have this tea, this will be good for you. Okay, so he insisted on drinking the tea to his master. Then he added, I have to go to the market for an hour or two, but I will be back in time to prepare dinner. Then the young boy told his master, he asked for his master's permission. He asked that he was going to the market for 1 or 2 hours. Okay, and he told, at the same time he told his master that he would be back from the market before the dinner time and he would prepare the dinner on the time. Now The old man nodded and thought. Nodded means yes. He gave the hint without uttering a word. Nodded, yes. Okay. And then he thought, while nodding, while giving permission to the boy, he thought to himself. And what did he think? He has been going to the market too often lately. I hope he hasn't fallen into bad company. Now the old man has had a doubt in his mind that the young boy Salim had been going to the market since a long time. So he hoped that he had not fallen in the company of bad people, or he had not fallen in bad company. He thought so. He had this fear that boy Salim should not fall in bad company, right? He shot a questioning glance at the boy, who turned and left the room. Now he was looking at Salim in a questioning way, as if he wanted to ask something, but he didn't ask, but his look was questioning. Okay, but the boy turned and left the room. The old man sighed and picked up the chisel and hammer. The cool metal of the tools filled him with happiness and confidence. He loved his work and didn't want to change it for any other in the world. Now what happened? The old man then, after Salim left the room, the old man again turned to his chisel and hammer. As he touched those things, those were made of metal. So the cool metals, the cool tools filled him with happiness. Okay. And he was busy in his work again. Okay. He was filled with confidence and he was busy in his work again. And he loved his work very much. And at any cost, he didn't want to change that work. Okay. Neither for any cost nor for anyone. He didn't want to change that work. Days and weeks went by. It was a month since Gopal had left. The old man worked tirelessly from morning till late at night. He worked on the sculpture. Okay, now days went by, days passed by, and days and weeks passed by, and it was a month since Gopal had left. Now the old man worked tirelessly. Tirelessly means without getting tired. He kept working day and night, from morning up to late at night. Okay, he kept working because he wanted to finish that sculpture. It was all there in the stone, the strong straight shoulders of Krishna, his soft carved hips. He could see the pointed figure holding the flute delicately to his lips, his serene face eternally beautiful. The old man could see it in the stone. He could feel it. He only had to set it free with his chisel. Now what happened? Actually, whatever statue he was carving in the stone, that statue was clear in his mind. That statue was clear in his imagination. Now the only thing what he had to do was, he had to set that statue free apart from that stone base. Okay, everything was clear to him. The lips of Krishna, the flute of Krishna, everything. Actually, he was carving the statue of Lord Krishna. Okay, so everything was clear in his mind. He just had to chisel it out or set it free with the help of hammer and chisel. He didn't feel hunger. He didn't feel thirst. He was driven by the desire to finish the sculpture in time. And while sculpting that, while carving that sculpture in the stone, he didn't feel any kind of hunger. He didn't feel any kind of thirst. He just wanted to finish that task within the time. It was his desire. It was his biggest piece, his best. It would also be the last. Okay, and he thought, the old stonemason thought, that this would be the biggest piece of his life that he had, that he will be, that he will carve out. It will be the best thing, best piece of his life that he will carve out. And perhaps this would be the last for him. Okay, means this might be the last piece of statue sculpture for him. On and on he worked, his chisel striking the stone again and again. But then came the day when the old man felt his strength ebb and his hands trembled under the impact of hammer. His shoulders began to ache, his arms felt heavy, and his eyes grew tired. Okay. Then his vision blurred and he could not see the shape of Krishna embedded in the stone. Overcome with fear, he sank to his knees and prayed. Now what happened? On and on he kept working without having anything, without drinking anything. He kept working and just wanted to finish that. But he was so tired that he started feeling weakness in his body. Okay, his hands were trembling. The hammer which was there in his hand, that was trembling. And the arms were feeling, he was feeling, his arms felt heavy. Okay, his vision was blurred. Okay, everything. Overall, he was feeling weakness in his body. Okay, so now he was not able to see the shape of Lord Krishna. Okay, that's why he was overcome with fear. And now he sat on his knees and he started praying to the God. Master Ji, Salim said, you haven't touched your food again. Please have some rice and vegetables. You only had a glass of milk for the breakfast and have the curd. You like the curd. I know you do. Okay. Now, meanwhile, Salim came back and when he saw that the meal was kept as it is and this old stone mason not even touched that food. So, looking at this thing, Salim insisted his master to have food. Okay. And he told his master, he requested his master to have food so that he may restored with the strength. Okay. And then he suggested his master to have some curd because the old stone mason liked the curd very much and Salim knew this thing. Okay. Besides this, in the morning, he had only a glass of milk as a breakfast. Right. Salim knew this thing. So he insisted his master to have food. The old man looked up. He whispered, I don't think I'll be able to finish it. If Gopal was here, it would be different. Okay. Then the old man looked up and he whispered. Now, why whispered? He got weak. He had got weak. So his voice, there was a low tone in his voice. Okay. And in that low tone, he told to Salim that I will not be able to finish that. He would not be able to finish that sculpture within the time. If Gopal were there, then that would be a different thing. Means the old man was thinking if Gopal had been there with him, so he would have been able to finish that task within the time. Okay. So he nodded absent-mindedly to himself and continued. Now the old man nodded to himself absent-mindedly. If Gopal had been here with me, he would have been able to finish this sculpture within the time. Okay. So he nodded and he continued. He wasn't the best of craftsmen, but he was good and strong. Now he is saying, the old stone mason is saying about his son. He is telling about his son that he wasn't a best of craftsmen. He was not so good in the craftsmanship, but he was good and strong enough. Okay. He chipped off the stone layer by layer as if it were a clay, and he chipped off the stones layer by layer in this way as if these are the layers of clay, just like the layers of clay. It was so easy for Gopal to chip off these stones from the big slab. Now, he hadn't yet learned to carve the finer details, but in a year or two he would have learned surely. Now the stone mason is accepting this thing that his son Gopal was not so good at the finer art in sculpting, in carving the sculptures. Okay, but within 1 or 2 years he would surely have learned the carving of sculptures. So in this video today, only this much, and very soon I will present in front of you with the new video. Thank you very much for watching.